And under decimals, we're talking about adding and subtracting. And under adding and subtracting them, please, in ginormous letters, the phrase that pays, Joel, is when you add and subtract decimals, you line them up. Or maybe I should say line up the decimal. Let's do that instead. Line. Up decimals. Line up the decimals. And that means this. If this is your problem, let's say you have 3.46 plus 0.2. So line up the decimal means this. We do it like an addition problem, 3.46. With the decimal point being here, you have to take and line up every decimal point after that on that same line. So when you add 0.2 there, it has to go like that. So those two decimals are on top of each other. And then in your answer, the decimal gets lined up on that same thing as well. You can always fill in empty decimal spaces with zeros. If it helps you, this will be 6, this will be 6, this will be 3.66. He thinks we've done this before, but that would be there. Same thing with subtracting decimals. If you have something like this, 0.543 minus 0.06, if you're writing that out, it would be 0.543 on this decimal point. You have to line up this 0.06, and again, you can add zeros if you like. In your answer, decimal goes on that. You don't really have to put that dash line there, but I'm doing it for emphasis. 0 from 3 is 3. You have to borrow from the 5, it becomes a 4. 14, 8, 4. That right? Maybe. Let me give you one to try. Again, this is fairly difficult here. How about 1.23 minus 0.4? 1.23 minus 0.4. Do that one for me. Where you sit. As you're sitting. Do that one. Maggie, what'd you come up with?
0.83.
Well, let's check and see. 1.23 minus, and again, everything's got to line up on that. 0.40. 3. This must be here. Borrow. 0.83 or just 0.83. Does anybody need any more on that, or shall we just proceed with caution?
Caution.
We shall proceed with caution. That's like a little review for you.